Hi everyone, welcome back to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. Today we've got a heart rate accuracy and comparison test between the Fitbit Luxe as well as the Xiaomi Mi Band 6. So I've been doing a long-term review of the Xiaomi Mi Band 6 just a while back, as well as the comparison between the Luxe and the Mi Band 6. And it did turn out that the Mi Band 6 does offer greater value in terms of a great display, great design, lots of functionality at only a third of the price from the Fitbit Luxe. But the only point of contention was the actual heart rate accuracy, because the Luxe did show itself very nicely against the Huawei Band 6. But now that we've done the test against the Xiaomi Mi Band 6, we were quite surprised as well. So here goes, let's get into the details in this test. So as per usual with the comparisons and test, we have a benchmark, and that is actually set by the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. So the strap is on me, on my chest, while I'm doing the workout, and that records the most accurate heart rate that can be done, well, physically to date, because the Polar H10 ECG chest strap is actually used by scientists and professional athletes, and so far and to date, it is the most accurate chest strap that can be found in the market. So that is our benchmark. So let's talk about the test rules. So what happened? I went to the gym, I got onto the treadmill, then I did a couple of core exercises as well as weights exercises just to keep up the heart rate and to keep it intense enough and to give us the steps that we need to actually attest to the accuracy of the optical heart rate sensors on the back of the two trackers. So let me tell you quickly about the two trackers and then we can get into the test results. Okay, so the Mi Band 6 is a truly budget fitness tracker. $40 will get you a 1.6 inch AMOLED display, fully touch activated, it looks absolutely amazing. 30 sport modes, all of them kept on your fitness tracker, and you get 6 auto-detected activities, which is amazing. Now, it does get connected GPS, as well as that it's 5 ATM water resistant. That means that you can take it to the shower, to the pool, because it will do your stroke recognition, it will count your number of laps, it will calculate your SWOLF, and in general, it's got all the other fitness tracker functionality, such as it's got a breathing widget, it can monitor your stress, it can monitor your sleep in 3 sleep stages, so your light, your deep, and REM sleep. The watch also gets an SpO2 monitor, so it does measure your blood oxygen saturation. Also, there's a world clock, there's the usual alarms, there's a weather widget, you can get your timer and stopwatch. All the rest of it is on there, but you get that for $40. In regards to the Fitbit Luxe, well, this is a premium fitness tracker. Well, that's how it's actually positioned by the marketing campaigns. But really all you're getting is a really big black face. And in the middle of it, there's a small AMOLED display, a rectangular display, which is less than 1 inch. So really quite tiny. It's also AMOLED, so it's also bright and crisp, but it is small. Fitbit is telling us that SpO2 is coming to it later via an OTA update. You get 20 sport modes, but only 6 are actually kept on the tracker. If you want to switch around the activities, you will have to go to your Fitbit app and choose a sport mode that you want on the watch from the actual app. Also, with the Fitbit Luxe, you actually get a 6-month premium subscription absolutely free, but you do have to splash out £130 or $130. So that is quite a bit. In regards to all the other features, well, you also get them on the Fitbit, right? You also get your silent alarms, you get your weather widget, you've got your timer, you've got your stopwatch, all the basic stuff is on there. So you get your light, your deep, and REM sleep monitored. So just in general, it looks like any other tracker, but it costs 3 times as much, it's got a much smaller screen. The purpose of this test is to attest to the accuracy or the heart rate accuracy of these two trackers, because really you do get a fitness tracker to identify and to monitor your heart rate or the intensity with which you perform certain activities. So let's have a look what the results were for the two trackers and set up against the benchmark, the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. So let's start off with the Polar H10 ECG chest strap results. So what we can see that over the 25 minutes, the average heart rate was measured at 109 beats per minute, while the max was registered at 131 beats per minute. Let's take a look at what the Fitbit Luxe came up with. And this is where things just get very interesting, because once again, the Fitbit Luxe, it just nailed it. The heart rate average was measured at 108 beats per minute. That's less than a percent off the mark. If we take a look at the max heart rate, it was measured at 132 beats per minute. And that is also less than 1% variance. That is, wow, astounding. And if we look at the two charts, we can see that the spikes do replicate each other. They go on track. And now if you take a look at the results from the Mi Band 6, this is unfortunate. So we can see that a budget tracker, it just didn't act as accurately as we expected. So we can see that the average heart rate was measured at 115 beats per minute. That's off by 6 beats per minute, or just over 5%. In regards to the max, it was off by 16 beats per minute, and that's 12.2%. That is quite a significant variance in such a small time frame. 25 minutes, well, it's not minuscule, but it's not large enough. And we can see that it's not just one spike causing this error. The first large spike on the actual plot, that's where the problem is. And it's not a single point on the plot. There are quite a number of points there, and they all seem to be driving up way too high. Well, these are the results. So what can we say? Well, yes, the Fitbit Luxe is the more dear option. It might not look as cool. It might lack some of the functionality. But if we talk about heart rate accuracy, as was proven with the test from the Huawei Band 6, as well as against this particular test against the Mi Band 6, the Fitbit Luxe heart rate accuracy of the optical heart rate sensor on the back of it is mighty good. Anyway, thank you for watching this comparison and test of the Xiaomi Mi Band 6 versus the Fitbit Luxe. If you enjoyed the test, please drop us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, you know what to do. Please click on the red subscribe button below the video. And we'll see you in the next one.